The European Agricultural Fund for Rural Development, known as the EAFRD, provides an important source of financial assistance for rural areas in the European Union. And the EAFRD is spent through rural development programs supporting tens of thousands of projects across rural Europe. The fund supports projects that produce a broad range of different benefits for European citizens. Improving food supplies, caring for the countryside, and investing in jobs are all top priorities for the EAFRD. Everybody needs food, and the EAFRD is one of Europe's main tools for helping to improve the way our food is produced. It helps businesses to invest in more cost-effective and environmentally friendly methods for producing food so that EU citizens can benefit from affordable, quality food that is healthy and tasty.
Os apoios do FIADER têm sido determinantes para modernizar a agricultura madeirense, acrescentar valor à atividade agrícola e obter produtos de qualidade. Uma das formas de valorizar e promover os produtos regionais é através de circuitos curtos que envolvem os agricultores locais, o comércio e o governo regional, que trabalhando em conjunto fomentam a marca Produto da Madeira. Mais de 4.300 produtores vendem os seus produtos com o selo da marca Madeira, distinguindo assim as suas produções regionais e as unidades agroindustriais das demais. No caso da banana da Madeira, toda a produção é coordenada pela GESBA, que é uma empresa pública que tutela o sector e que faz a coordenação da venda da banana na região.
A produção começou em agosto a setembro, mais ou menos, do ano passado. E a marca Madeira está através da GESBA, que é que nos compra o produto. Portanto, os apoios da comunidade europeia vieram contribuir muito para a rentabilização desta exploração. Se não fossem esses apoios, não era fácil pôr isto como está e pôr a produzir como está. Portanto, os fundos europeus que apoiaram esta exploração tornaram muito mais competitiva no mercado e muito mais rentável.
Ao trabalharem em rede, desde os produtores aos consumidores, todos podem beneficiar de uma linha de abastecimento forte e de produtos alimentares mais confiáveis.
Сетка до България влезе в Европейския съюз и ни бяха предоставени възможности да използваме европейските фондове за инвестиране в преработката на замразени плодове и зеленчуци, искахме тези машини да отговарят на нашите изисквания, да имат висока производителност, високо качество на производството, да бъдат с по-занижени разходи при самата обработка, да имат високи хигиенни изисквания, които да отговарят на международните стандарти за безопасност на храните. Ето, това ни наложи да сключим договор с Държавен фонд земеделие и да закупим такава машина. Този иновационен проект има както социален, така и икономически ефект, както за фирмата, така и за региона. Ние повишихме с 50% нашата производителност, открихме нови работни места, 15 само за 6 месеца. За общината той също има социален ефект. Над 100 производители имаме директни договори, които са обвързани с нашия хладилник. Но индиректно са включени над 1000 човека, които при обработката и при брането на малините са включени в прибирането на тази толкова нежна продукция. Смятаме, че по този начин ние помагаме на общината, помагаме на хората и по този начин даваме обществена заетост за всички в региона. Смятаме, че това е един прекрасен проект, който ще продължава да има положителен ефект върху нашия регион.
Wij produceren 2400 ton hoogwaardige oranje paprika's per jaar. Het EU-fonds heeft het ons mogelijk gemaakt over te schakelen op duurzame warmte. Wij gebruiken deze warmte voor de teelt van onze hoogwaardige producten. Daartoe zijn wij nu aangesloten op onze nieuwe geothermie-installatie, die mogelijk gemaakt is door een bijdrage uit het EU-fonds.
Het project Klima Westland is tot stand gekomen met 2 miljoen subsidie van de Europese gemeenschap. En hiermee pompen wij van 2800 meter diepte warm water naar boven om onze kassen te verwarmen. Het project voldoet aan 2 doelstellingen. We hebben een gigantische besparing op aardgas, dus op fossiele brandstoffen. En daarbij we besparen gigantisch veel op het milieu, om ongeveer 10 miljoen kubieke meter CO2 wat wij minder uitstoten per jaar. We zijn dit project met 5 bedrijven gestart, omdat we allemaal niet kleinere bedrijven hebben. En het is heel belangrijk dat je een hele goede samenwerking hebt, zodat je dit project tot een eind kan brengen. Na het geologisch onderzoek bleek dat we nog meer warmte hadden. En dat wij gaan draaien ook. Dus we hebben inmiddels nog 5 andere bedrijven aangesloten. Dus we draaien nu met 10 bedrijven op dit project. Aardwarmteprojecten hebben een grote bijdrage in het leveren op CO2-besparingen. Dus daardoor halen regeringen waarschijnlijk ook de afspraken om in 2020 de doelstellingen te halen. Dus het zijn alleen maar positieve dingen voor het milieu.
Rural areas are home to the majority of Europe's wildlife species. And our countryside hosts a huge variety of traditional European landscapes. Agriculture and forestry land users receive EAFRD support to help them cover some of the costs involved in taking care of Europe's soil, water and biodiversity, as well as looking after traditional landscapes. In addition, the EAFRD is also very useful for helping rural communities to increase their ability for dealing with the effects of changing climate patterns.
Voilà, donc je viens de reprendre la ferme familiale avec ma sœur aînée il y a maintenant environ 2 ans. Qui dit reprise de ferme dit quand même pas mal de projets. Donc ici cette année, on va restaurer notre point de vente en y ajoutant également une chambre froide et un atelier réfrigéré. Et on voudrait aussi construire une bergerie pour doubler notre cheptel de moutons. Donc évidemment, qui dit projet dit augmentation des coûts d'énergie et de la consommation d'énergie. Donc ça nous semblait naturel de mettre des panneaux solaires sur la ferme. Ici, nous avons introduit un plan d'investissement pour tous nos projets et donc ça permet d'avoir quand même un subside de la région Wallonne et de l'Europe de jusqu'à 27%. Donc voilà, ce n'est pas du tout négligeable dans notre cas. Et j'ai également un supplément en tant que jeune agricultrice, donc voilà, ce sont vraiment des subsides importants. Ça nous permet d'avoir les panneaux, de réduire nos coûts de production, mais également de donner un peu notre touche environnementale par rapport à nos projets.
We have created some beetle banks around the edge of fields. We leave a strip of 2 to 3 meters unplowed. We do the beetle banks because it's important for these insects because they're so part of the food chain and for the ecosystem of each of these fields. We also have gone into away wintering of sheep. So we've taken some of the sheep off these lower hills and we've put them away so these areas have had a chance to regenerate naturally. And there's no chance of poaching through the winter, the sheep's feet making holes and going over nests that are already there. And we've had funding for these things as well, which has been very helpful. Well, the funding is very important because if we didn't have the funding, for example, fields like this, we would put sheep in them all year round because grass is a rare commodity here in spring. We're short of grass because of the climate. And so if we didn't have the funding, we certainly wouldn't keep the sheep off of that. And then there's, because of that, there's a real benefit to the environment and to the local community in that these places have become a good habitat for some of the species that we're trying to increase in our area. because of what we've done with some of the prescriptions and the funding we've been receiving, it helps the local community, because this being in the national park, there are many bird watchers who come and they see the environment we've created and the habitat, and they would stay locally and come and enjoy this and then spend money in the shops and in our own rural economy. So we believe there's a good benefit there as well. The money we've received from the Rural Development Programme has been used on the environmental things, but it's also helped us increase our business. As a result, we believe the farm has become more effective in producing food and also looking after the countryside.
Τα προγράμματα ανάπτυξης της ΕΑΦΡΔ έχουν χρησιμοποιηθεί και στην Ελλάδα ως ένα πολύτιμο μέσο για να διατηρηθεί το εισόδημα των αγροτών, έτσι ώστε αυτοί να μπορούν να μας προσφέρουν όχι μόνο τρόφιμα, αλλά και να διαχειρίζονται την ύπαιθρο και το περιβάλλον. Εδώ στη Λέσβο, για παράδειγμα, που σε ένα μεγάλο κομμάτι του νησιού έχουμε ιδιαίτερες εδαφοκλιματικές συνθήκες, χωρίς την ύπαρξη αυτών των προγραμμάτων ανάπτυξης της ΕΑΦΡΔ, θα ήταν δύσκολο για πολλούς από τους αγρότες να συνεχίσουν να παραμείνουν αγρότες και να διαχειρίζονται τη γη. Και αυτό μπορεί να έχει αρνητικές επιπτώσεις στο περιβάλλον και στα πολιτισμικά τοπία, όπως αυτό το υπέροχο αγροδασικό παραδοσιακό τοπίο που βλέπετε πίσω μου. Τα τοπία αυτά βοηθούν και στην προσέλκυση τουριστών στην ύπαιθρο. Εκτός από αυτό όμως, όλα τα αγροδασικά συστήματα αποτελούν θαυμάσιους βιότοπους για την άγρια ζωή. Εκτός από αυτό, τα αγροδασικά συστήματα είναι ιδιαίτερα πολύτιμα για τη διατήρηση του εδάφους. Οι ρίζες βοηθούν στο να κρατηθεί το έδαφος και να μειωθούν σημαντικά τα φαινόμενα διάβρωσης, κάτι το οποίο είναι ιδιαίτερα σημαντικό κυρίως σε αυτές τις ξηροθερμικές συνθήκες.
Η οικογένειά μου από χρόνια είναι σε αυτή τη δουλειά, σε αυτό το επάγγελμα. Με αυτό ξεκινήσαμε. Και εντάξει, δεν πιστεύω ότι είναι κάποιο εύκολο επάγγελμα. Είναι δύσκολο, πολύ δύσκολο είναι. Οι βελανιδιές μας βοηθάνε, καταρχήν είναι ένα δέντρο που κάνει καρπό, που τον οποίο τον τρώνε τα πρόβατα. Και είναι μια πολύ καλή τροφή, πιο καλή και από τη ζωοτροφή. Και το άλλο είναι ότι καταρχήν έχει ίσιο το χωράφι μέσα. Είναι καλό να υπάρχουν τέτοια δέντρα μέσα σε ένα χωράφι, ας το πούμε. Το τοπίο χωρίς τα δέντρα για μένα δεν ήταν καλό. Οι επιδοτήσεις μας έχουν βοηθήσει ώστε να προστατευτούν οι δουλειές στο χωριό και στο περιβάλλον φυσικά.
The EAFRD has helped people around the EU to take advantage of employment opportunities and to promote innovation and entrepreneurship in rural areas. The fund has put a special focus on creating new jobs for priority groups like young people and women living in rural areas.
Pasinaudodami jaunų ūkininkų įsikūrimo programą, mes pateikėme verslo planą, kuriame prašėme suteikti finansinę paramą įsigyti naujai moderniai žemės ūkio dirbimo techniką. Technika įsigyta pasinaudojus ES paramos fondų skirtomis lėšomis, jinai padėjo labai stipriai modernizuoti mano ūkį. Visų pirma, labai pagreitino darbą. Visų antra, žymiai reikalauja mažiau fizinio darbo krūvio ir tai sąlygoja geresnį, modernesnį mano ūkio stovį, kas leidžia konkuruoti su visais kitais ūkiais, kas leidžia užauginti geresnės kokybės produkciją, kadangi laiku atliekamas darbas ir kokybiškai atliekamas darbas. Ir be abejo, tai takoja būtent gerą laukų stovį bei puikų produkcijos kiekį bei gausų derlių.
Somos una empresa industrial de lavados cárnicos, principalmente de frescos, ahumados y cocidos. La calidad contrastada de nuestros productos, así como la mejora tecnológica y constante, es la base de nuestro crecimiento y desarrollo. objetivo principal del proyecto ha sido continuar con el crecimiento de nuestra industria, principalmente en aquellos productos elaborados con carne picada, pinchos y brochetas. Los fondos FEADER nos han ayudado en la modernización de nuestros procesos productivos y en la eficiencia de nuestros procesos. En consecuencia, hemos consolidado nuestro negocio y, lo que es más importante, hemos creado 30 nuevos puestos de trabajo, de los cuales 15 son de personal femenino.
The EAFRD continues to be the main source of finance for these types of rural development projects, and member states can count on it to support smart, sustainable, and inclusive growth in European rural areas. By doing so, the fund helps to ensure that Europe's countryside remains an attractive place to live, work, and visit. For further information about the EAFRD in your country, connect with the website of the European Network for Rural Development.